But there is some data that is so sensitive, no matter how many certifications we have, you're still nervous about putting it in a database as a service. Let's take a look at an example. Here's a document. It's got a social security number in it. No MongoDB employee would let me put their social security number on the screen. I tried. None of them would do it. Why? It's private. You don't want it leaked. You don't want anyone to see it. Storing this document in Atlas might be a little scary. Storing this document in Atlas, not scary at all. You want to encrypt the key fields. You can, of course, in your application, encrypt any fields you want. But it's kind of a pain. So we decided to make it really, really easy. So in 4.2, we've got a new feature called field level encryption. So first, field level encryption happens entirely client side. It's built into every single MongoDB driver. The driver will encrypt the data before it leaves the driver, and it will only be decrypted when it gets back to the driver. This all happens completely transparently to the developers. The MongoDB API doesn't change. You configure this when you configure the connection, and then when you insert a document using the exact same API, behind the scenes, the driver is going to encrypt the fields you want encrypted, send it to the database, and it's only decrypted when it comes back to the driver. The database never, ever sees the clear text. The most powerful part of this, though, is how you choose the encryption key. There's a lot of options here. You can have an encryption field, an encryption key per collection, an encryption field, encryption key per field. Or my favorite, you can have an encryption key per user. You can say, I want to use one encryption key for every user for every collection. So all of Elliot's data across all my collections is encrypted using the same key. Why is that so powerful? So now Elliot's got one key. Everyone else has a different key. Well, everyone has their own key. Now let's say I want to delete Elliot. You're like, get rid of this guy. What do you do? Deleting Elliot's documents, it's annoying, but you could do it. But if there's a lot of data, maybe it'll take a while. But what about all your backups? Are you going to delete Elliot's data from every one of your backups? Sounds like a nightmare. You're all thinking right now, how would I do that? You can't. What you can do is delete Elliot's encryption key. And now all the data you have stored about Elliot, gone. You've basically wiped me off the planet, exactly like you want to do.